It's been 2 years since the Mazda CX-3 launched in Australia, and here we have its first refresh. You wouldn't pick it from outside or inside, except the steering wheel and speedometer is ever so different, because it's pretty much business as usual. But is that such a bad thing? The CX-3 is the biggest volume-selling small SUV under $40,000, and its design, which hasn't changed, is consistent with the current crop of new models such as the CX-9 and CX-5. What is it? Outselling rivals such as the Mitsubishi ASX, Nissan Qashqai and Honda HR-V, the CX-3 has been well received since it landed in 2015 thanks to its modern Kodo design language, and just 2 years on, Mazda hasn't had to lift the pen as it still looks sharp amongst the competition. Head of Mazda product division, Minoru Takada, elaborates on the lack of aesthetic update by saying it's a matter of avoiding changes for change's sake. Fair enough. So instead we get some differences under the skin. Mazda's G-vectoring control is now standard across the range, and it promises to improve dynamic ability and stability. GVC works by reducing engine power, when required, so that the vehicle shifts more weight over the front of the vehicle and is better balanced for improved cornering performance. There has been a few other tweaks to handling too, including a redesigned bushing control arm, decreasing resistance by 40%, tuning of dampers, and tweaks to the rear multi-link bushing. All up, it should see the CX-3 handle sharper and provide a smoother ride. Other enhancements include better NVH, improved engine sound, and electric front seats with two memory positions. But the headline is that the 2017 CX-3 leads its segment with the best standard of safety across the entire model range. All models now get Mazda's Smart City Brake Support, or Autonomous Electronic Braking, AEB, which functions in both forward and reverse movements. It is standard from the base model Neo and sets a benchmark for some other manufacturers to follow. Curiously, a reverse camera is not standard in Neo and will set buyers back around $500, a more common feature usually found standard. Other safety features are blind spot monitoring and rear cross safety alert standard on Max model. Driver attention alert and traffic sign recognition on S Touring and Akari models. And adaptive LED headlights and front parking sensors on Akari model. All models are available with either a 2.0-liter four-cylinder petrol producing 109 kilowatts per 192 newton meters, or a 1.5-liter diesel turbo producing 77 kilowatts per 270 newton meters. Both are available in a variety of front-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, and manual or automatic transmissions. What's the interior like? The CX-3 is based on the Mazda 2 platform and isn't particularly spacious inside. Main pinch points are width and second row legroom, but up front there was enough room to accommodate 2 6-foot-tall guys. The driver's seat has a good amount of adjustment available, although it doesn't drop particularly low, and the steering wheel provides tilt and reach movement. The interior presents well and, like the exterior, is consistent with Mazda's latest products. Not much has changed from the previous model CX-3 though, and it essentially feels the same. The 7.0-inch infotainment screen from the previous model carries over, and there's still no Apple CarPlay or Android Auto connectivity. The Mazda infotainment software is easy to navigate, and the center console rotary dial and button saves fumbling on a touchscreen. Up front there's also 2 USB ports for charging devices, 2 cup holders in the center and 1 in each door. In the second row there's limited space, and it is better suited to 2 or 3 kids rather than adults. The fabric seats in our test vehicle were comfortable front and rear, but the rear doesn't have as much padding as the front units. The boot shows the most sacrifice of space, with a small 264 liters available, far less than the Honda HR-V's 437 meters, but thankfully the rear seats split fold 60-40 and increase space to 1174 liters. The boot opening doesn't offer a great amount of width either, so loading a set of golf clubs in the boot would be a challenge. What's it like on the road? The launch route for the CX-3 wasn't particularly long or varied, so we didn't get the chance to properly experience the enhancements from GVC or improved damper tuning, and we were only able to drive the automatic equipped 2.0-liter four-cylinder petrol FWD. During our time in the outer suburbs of Melbourne, the CX-3 felt similar to its smaller sibling the Mazda 2 and has a light and sharp hatchback feel to its handling. Negotiating traffic is easier than larger SUVs, thanks to its small size, but it does also feel less substantial than its larger stablemates, if that's your thing. We really didn't get an opportunity to feel the GVC working, but the CX-3 retains its tight chassis and is capable of fun Sunday drives. The 2.0-liter petrol provides the most grunt and is probably money better saved if you don't need diesel, although the diesel is the most frugal with a combined consumption of 4.4 L/100 km compared to the petrol's 6.7 L/100 km. The refreshed CX-3 engine apparently provides a nicer sound higher in the revs, but it's hard to discern unless testing back-to-back. Improvements to NVH were equally hard to discern, but the CX-3 never had much of a problem with it anyway. What about safety features? The CX-3 has a 5-star ANCAP rating and features autonomous electronic braking across the entire range as standard. Other safety features, depending on grade, include blind spot monitoring, rear cross safety alert, driver attention alert, traffic sign recognition, adaptive LED headlights and front parking sensors. Why would you buy one? The CX-3's appealing styling and easy-to-drive feeling will continue to help its sales success. For small families, there isn't the space required to haul gear, unless you're a Tetris master, but if you don't need the space, then the CX-3 provides a good level of safety from the base spec and has a well-sorted interior.